Now, find the roots of the following function. M of x is equal to x cubed plus 5x squared minus 24x. Now, what we need to remember is, when finding the roots, then M of x is equal to 0. Then M of x is equal to 0. Therefore, where there is M of x, we replace with 0. So 0 is equal to x cubed plus 5x squared minus 24x. Now, we need to make this a quadratic equation. What do? X is common. Therefore, we divide through the equation by x. We divide each and every member of the equation by x. So, x and x will go. X here is 1, x here is x. X here is 1, x here is x squared. Now, what is our new equation? 0 is equal to x squared plus 5x minus 24. Now, looking at this, then we say, we solve now this using factorization method. Therefore, now from here, we come and solve it here. So, what do we have? We have our product as being A and C. A multiplied by C. The coefficient of x squared, which is A, by the constant term, which is C. So our product will be 1 times negative 24. Our product is negative 24. While our sum is the coefficient of x, which is 5. Now, we look for two numbers. If we add them, we get 5. And if we multiply them, we get negative 24. What are the numbers? So we shall say the two numbers are positive 8 and negative 3. If you add 8 plus negative 3, the sum is 5. 8 multiplied by negative 3, the product is negative 24. Now we come here and expand the coefficient of x. Therefore, now we have 0 is equal to x squared plus 8x minus 3x minus 24. Then now what do? After having expanded the coefficient of x, we now factorize them in groups of 2. We now factorize them in groups of 2. So what is common here? X is common. Is equal to 0 into x plus 8. What is common here? 3 is common because 3 can go into 3x and 3 can also go into 24. So minus 3 into bracket x. Because of this negative, we want to maintain this negative here. Therefore, this becomes plus 8. This one here becomes plus 8. Now, this one and this one are the same. So we pick one of them. So what do we have? We have x plus 8. All this is equal to 0. Then we have x minus 3. Now we equate each and every one of them is equal to 0. So 0 is equal to x plus 8. Whereby now x is equal to negative 8 or x is equal to positive 3. Whereby when we are saying now x minus 3 is equal to 0. So we shall say x is equal to positive 3. So we have this answer and this answer. Therefore, now what I say, the roots of x are equal to negative 8 or positive 3. So that becomes our answer. It's okay.